you did it. Made a way. Standing here, not knowing how we'll get through this test, but holding on to faith you know best. Nothing can catch you by surprise. You got this figured out, and you're watching us now. And when it looks as if we can't win, wrap us in your arms and step in. And everything we need you supply. You got this in control, and now we know that you made a way.
When our backs were against the wall, and it looked as if it was over,
Lord, you made a way. And we're standing here,
and we're standing here,
only because
you made a way.
Hey everybody, we are so excited about the time we had today. Shiloh in the Park had a wonderful time with fellowshipping with friends and family, the community. You know, we wish those of you could not have made it, we wish you had been here. Next time you'll have to come out. It was a fantastic time. I'm here with Elder Jose Wilson, who's one of the leaders in the community. As a matter of fact, you know, one might consider him to be the mayor of Park Manor. He is the head. He made sure that things were in place here at Myron Park. Elder Jose, what did you think of today?
Elder Pine, this day was absolutely phenomenal. You know, we started the relationship with the community about 2 years ago. And so the goal is to actually help to revitalize and transform. And Shiloh has been an active member every Sabbath afternoon. We're connecting with meeting people and helping to revitalize and create safe recreational places for people in our community. We're so thankful. And Sister Pam, you know, what a wonderful job you did. You was on fire today.
Thank you. You know what? I just want to say that we couldn't have done this without the people in the community and without the elders and the pastors and everyone that showed up today. This was just awesome, and a lot of the kids from the community came out. It was definitely more than we expected, so we are happy, and hopefully we'll do this next year and see you soon.
Every person's life, every person's heart, every person's journey, and you are loved by God. You are not forgotten. You are not overlooked. And the things that are happening in your life, the bad things did not come from God. The word of God, which has survived thousands of years, says that only good and perfect gifts come from above. But we do live in a very difficult, painful world, and God is able to take all of the ashes from the burned things in our lives, and He is the only one that can make beauty from ashes. I'm not going to preach, but I'm going to pray, and I'll share this verse with you. It is the most translated verse in all the world. And it was not a verse preached. It wasn't a sermon. There was no church. It was a one-on-one conversation with a man that said, I got a lot in my life, but I want what you have, Jesus. And Jesus said, for God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in Him, and Jesus, would not perish, but have everlasting life. For God did not send His Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through Him might be saved. I want to pray for you right now. Father, in Jesus' name, we pray for safety over every child and family that is represented here. God, I pray that you would bring healing and help and power and courage to every experience, for the relationships that may be struggling and strained. God, I pray you bring clarity and peace. For those that may be displaced and homeless or in shelters, God, I pray that you would remind them they are not forgotten. For those that only could eat here because there's nothing to eat at home, Lord, I pray that they would know you have a plan to provide. Father, for every person that is not well, Lord, I pray that you bring healing. And for every mind that is clouded and struggling, I pray, oh God, that you bring peace. In Jesus' name, we look forward to the day when sin, death, disease, and crime will be no more. Until then, we love you, God. In Jesus' name, amen.